is, and let's talk about like what I mean by that and what we mean by that. But also expectations, they can be really important too, if you want to be creating and all that. But if we get too attached, they can cause a lot of suffering. And our ability to know when our expectations are serving us and when they're costing us is really, really important. So if I were to talk about visioning for 1 second, I think that the normal human animal doesn't take their vision far enough. I feel like it almost feels like there's a cognitive cost to imagining at that level.
Okay.
Many of us bounce off that, just dealing with our day to day, we end up going with the default and following existing habits, whether they serve us or they don't. And we don't get creative enough about what we really can create or manifest or build, et cetera. And so the action or the act of learning how to really try to see a future, I have a thing called future visioning where we actually use something else I use called future writing, where we actually write about the future in a way where we get really creative about what things might look like in the future, looking at different dimensions of your world. So who are you hanging out with? Have you made new and powerful friends? What kind of clothes are you wearing? Where are you living, et cetera, right? Describe that really clearly and give yourself the freedom to write whatever's inspiring, creative, and fun. And again, if you're not writing this, just in your imagination, imagine what's inspiring and fun. And then kind of back up from there and go, what happened right before that that had to happen, right? What happened right before that that had to happen? So we're looking at it in reverse rather than trying to see it from here. Because one of the biggest challenges of seeing things from here, especially for smart people, we end up noticing all the difficult things that are involved in getting to that next step. And to get past some of those challenges, you need to be inspired by the bigger vision. You need to do that.
Right.
If you look at it backwards, you end up getting, okay, this is real clarity on what I want in great detail, detail that's beyond what most people will spend their time and attention creating. And then I go back and I can now find really creative solutions to get to that. And from that reverse way, it tends to make more invisible some of the challenges that may come up along the way and really carves a much more creative and possible path to much bigger creation, et cetera.